All right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Jay Cheatham. He is the CEO of Pantheon Resources. And Jay, welcome back. Good to see you.
Good to see you again, Steve.
And also joining us is your technical director, Bob Rosenthal. And Bob, always great to see you as well.
Good to see you too.
So an interesting update out from the company, Jay, talking about getting Alkaid number 2 back into production. And it's not exactly what you were hoping to see. And maybe you could sort of take us through the process and explain to us what's going on.
Okay, Steve. Well, we came out with this operational update today. And we stated that we were getting an IP30 rate, and I'll explain a little more about that, of 505, just a little over 500 barrels of Alaskan North Slope crude oil condensate, NGLs, from the Alkaid number 2 well after our latest cleanout. Now, we had hoped that our latest cleanout, and I know we talked to you sometime in the past, we'd hoped our latest cleanout would give us a little more of a boost. But we didn't get the boost we were hoping for. But what we are seeing is, along with this crude and condensate, is we're getting an awful lot of natural gas. And that's what's helping us with some of the NGLs. And so we have great deliverability in the reservoir. And Bob will talk a little more about that afterwards. So we gave guidance in the past that we'd have an IP, basically an IP1, of 750 barrels a day, and then it would decline some. And what we've got now is an IP30, which for us is kind of an average over 30 days. We haven't, since we've brought this well on three times over the past several months, we don't have 30 days consecutive to actually give an IP30, but we have calculated an average of over 30 days. So, Steve, the market was expecting really an uplift after this latest cleanout, and we really didn't deliver that uplift that the market was expecting, and so there was some disappointment. However, you know, we have 153,000 acres, and this is less than 4% of our resource base there, so there's still a lot to play for. We've de-risked the entire play. And, you know, we're not as disappointed as basically the market was with this outcome.
Yeah, Bob, maybe you can take it from here and just sort of explain to us on the technical side what it is you're seeing.
Well, we're seeing, as Jay say, we're seeing a rate of about 500 barrels a day of oil and condensate, which in normal circumstances would be considered a pretty good result. We did give the guidance of 750, but this was our first, you know, this was our first horizontal well and our first test of the reservoir. One of the things we've seen is we're seeing more gas than what we expected, and the overall most likely probability for that is twofold. One is we've intersected a small gas cap. And secondly, the gas is coming out of solution from the formation, and we're seeing gas from that. So we're seeing a combination from both of those. And since we have so much gas, it kind of impedes the amount of oil you're going to be producing. So the one thing we're going to be doing in the future is looking where can we drill the well and position the well such that we, you know, don't produce the same amount of gas. And that could just be as simple as, because we have such a thick section, simply just drill the well slightly deeper. So yeah, I mean, this is a learning process. It's our first well. We are producing, over 500 barrels a day of, like Jay said, that's an ANS crude in Alaska. They don't differentiate between the condensate and the oil. And we feel we can do better in the future. I mean, it's not a big leap to say that, you know, when you've drilled with these horizontal wells, they improve with time as you go through the learning process. Yeah, Steve, and I'd just like to make one other point. And this reservoir is performing much better than expected. We've been, we've been on production now for almost 60 days, and this well has been flowing for that whole period of time. We expected that we would need lift to collect this data, and it has been flowing. And the amount of hydrocarbons we're producing, 500 barrels a day of, you know, oil and condensate and 2.5 million cubic feet a day of gas, this is performing really, really well. And it's the deliverability of the reservoirs that was the big question prior to this test. And I think we've answered the question that these reservoirs can really deliver.
So Jay, is that the next step now to sort of to start looking at another well and make those changes as Bob suggested?
Well, Steve, in the short term, there are several things we can do. And as you can imagine, we've had a lot of conversations with shareholders today on the back of this result. And the shareholders are saying, okay, when are you going to be able to bring in a farm-in partner? And Bob is working diligently with our partner, SLB, formerly known as Schlumberger, to get a data room open. But there are a couple of things that we can do that are less costly than drilling a new well, Steve. We have two vertical well bores in the Alkaid anomaly. The Alkaid number one that we tested in 2019, and the Alkaid number two, the vertical prior to when we went horizontal, have both penetrated the shelf margin deltaic, which is above the Alkaid anomaly. And we could re-enter both of those, either one or both of those well bores, and test the shelf margin deltaic, which is a reservoir that has between 5 to 6 times the amount of potential resource than the Alkaid. So those we can do for plus or minus $5 million. We will look at that, and you know, Bob, real soon we'll have the data room open, and we'll be looking, hopefully bring in a partner, farm in E.
Yeah. So just, can I add to that? These are relatively cheap options to really move the needle on, you know, kind of, you know, the next step. We have not been able to test the shelf margin deltaic in the past, and the ability to re-enter these boreholes is, you know, is extremely cheap option to go out and prove up a lot of hydrocarbons. Superimposed on that is the fact that this shelf margin deltaic sits right on top of the Alkaid anomaly. And so, you know, proving that up and being able to discuss, you know, the economics of developing that and Alkaid together massively changes the economics on the Alkaid well. And I'd just like to add one other point to that is, you know, people who are not sort of knowledgeable in the business are saying, you know, kind of ask, well, you've told us in the past the shelf margin deltaic is, you know, really good and it's better than the, you know, Alkaid. You know, why don't you test that first? And the answer is you got to test the stuff deeper first, you know, and move up the borehole. That's in terms of using the same borehole. But the other thing is we had a really good test at Alkaid 1, and we were following that out up with Alkaid 2. And then it was Alkaid 2 where we saw we had a really nice, a good section of the shelf margin deltaic, and it was, you know, oil bearing. So, you know, kind of in the back of our minds was the plan of maybe moving up the borehole and using that borehole to test out the shelf margin deltaic.
No, super point, Bob. Yeah, great point.
All right, gentlemen, we'll leave it there. I know there's lots of work to come, and I hope to get you back for an update on when you make decisions on which way you're going to be heading forward. But Jay, I appreciate you coming on, and Bob, you as well, to sort of talk through what has been a bit of a fact-finding mission for a lot of shareholders and everyone else. So, gentlemen, thank you so much.
Thanks, Dave.
Thank you.
Day for us.
All right. There's, yes, Bob Rosenthal, the technical director, and Jay Cheatham, the CEO of Pantheon Resources.